We all need water to survive, to grow our food, as well as to sustain our societies. As populations increase, so does our demand for freshwater resources. So how can we conserve and preserve these precious resources, especially in regions who are already experiencing water scarcity? The answers sometimes lie inside of the challenge. Inspired by nature, advances in science are springing in the Gulf region. In the heat of the sun, there is power. And from insects whose bodies repel water, there is a model to protect soil. Solutions are in the form of conservation efforts that range from wastewater treatment and reuse, solar energy for desalinization, and being able to grow more food with less water.
Now, the 2030 goal of the Saudi government is to optimize all its resources. Energy is one of the largest resources. And then we discussed today that water is also a requirement, a precursor to life, actually, for not only for the people, but for the industry to survive.
We are in Saudi Arabia, a very water scarce nation. Saudi Aramco has recognized this challenge for a long time, both a water conservation policy and strategy to deal with these challenges. The concept is that for anybody or a project to utilize groundwater, there is a cost, and this cost is equivalent to the transport of a desalinated water to that project location. That drives, projects to really evaluate alternatives for utilizing groundwater.
In fact, it is not a surprise that the country's 2030 program calls for reducing their water consumption for agriculture by up to 50%. This is not 1, 2, 3, this is 15%. Imagine taking a 50% salary cut. This will change your life. 50% is very, very difficult. And if I tell you that agriculture is the biggest consumer of groundwater, which is the biggest water content used on the planet, so it's not desal, it's not industry, it's growing food that consumes the most water. So that's why we focus in my group on trying to attack that problem. Even if you make 1% difference, it will go a long way.
I work in Saudi Arabia, so I wanted to use an abundant material that would be cheap and environmentally friendly to solve this problem. So if I look around in Saudi Arabia, the most abundant material is sand, I suppose. So we started thinking how we can use sand. The material is inspired by nature. In many natural systems, like plants, like many insects, especially the insect that lives on the surface of water for the rest of its life, staying dry is very, very important. But how do you stay dry if you live on the surface of water? So they have really evolved some really fascinating strategies of doing so. So we studied them, and then we learned their secrets. And then we apply those secrets to these really common and inexpensive materials to make our material. What we have achieved is by combining two very inexpensive materials, sand and paraffin wax, this material that is super water repellent. It is very, very dry. When we place it on top of wet soil, so the top layer is very, very dry. So when the solar radiation hits or when winds blow, they do not touch wet soil. They touch the dry sand layer. Hence, they don't suck as much water.
Conserving water helps reduce energy, it protects our forests, and it helps us to mitigate the impacts of climate change.
How it's important for COP24? Because less energy usage would emit less pollution into the environment. Less pollution in the environment resulting into the less GHG in our planet, and then we are having a sustainable solution for our problems. This is how it all connects up.
Water and energy are inextricably linked. In the power generation, we use a lot of water for cooling purpose. In desalination, we need the power to run the pumps which produce the pressure, or we need basically pump the water around. So basically both need each other. So no power generation without water and no water desalination without power. And so the big goal is really to decarbonize the desalination and the power generation, and the way we fit is renewable energy and desalination.
The solutions that can survive the hot, dry deserts of Saudi Arabia have the potential to deliver results to the entire world. Inspired by nature and fortified in science, we can all look forward to a sustainable tomorrow.